Dear students, very good morning. Myself Ankit Tayal and I am Senior Assistant Professor in the Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering at ABES Engineering College, Ghaziabad. This is the first video lecture regarding network analysis and synthesis. And in this lecture, we will introduce the transient circuit analysis. This is a basic circuit analysis. Now let me we will cover the syllabus. Introduction to transient response analysis. Second, the difference between transient analysis and steady state analysis. And third, circuit analysis using Laplace transform. Basically, its formula and its circuit representation. We will be having a discussion in this lecture. Okay. Now, let me come to the transient response analysis. So, firstly, let me discuss about what is transient analysis. You know, whenever there is a change in the circuit, the voltage or the current changes in the given circuit. That can be done by the change in resistance, or that can be done by any switching in the circuit. You know, these changes take place after a short interval of time. Means we are talking about the change in current. There was some current flowing in the circuit, and after that change, again there will be some current flowing in the circuit. But there is a short interval of time, and this time is called the transient time. And the value of these variables, voltage or current, during transient time is called the transient values. So beyond transient time, the steady state takes place. Now, what is actually switching? That is more important. Switching means either we are talking about the switch to be closed or the switch to be opened. Now, I have mentioned here the switch is closed at t equal to 0 or the switch is open at t equal to 0. But it means the switch can be closed at any time or the switch can be opened at any time. The time may be t equal to 0 or t equal to 5 milliseconds or maybe t equal to infinity, any time. Now let me come to this input output system. Let me say we have given some input to any system and we will get some output. So this output depends upon two things. First, the input. The input may be the DC or the AC. Now let me discuss about the system. If you are talking about the system may be the first order system or the second order system. And while we are talking about the switching means we are changing in the system. And according to this change in the system, we will get some different output. So we are actually interested about to have a study of this output. Okay. Now as far as concerned about the analysis part of this output, we are having two approaches. First is called classical approach or differential equation approach, and second is called the Laplace transform approach. And in this lecture, we will introduce this Laplace transform approach. Now, interestingly, while you are talking about the first order system consists of one resistance, and it can consist of one inductance or one capacitance. It means the circuit must be an RL circuit or an RC circuit. ठीक है? Now second is the second order system. In second order system, one inductor and one capacitor is must. It means it must be an LC circuit, but with or without resistance. So it means the circuit will be RLC circuit or the circuit may be an LC circuit. And just to remind you, the inductance and capacitance are the energy storing elements, and because of these, the transient occurs in the circuit. Fine. Now, as I mentioned, we will be having some discussion about the circuit analysis using Laplace transform. So, let me discuss about some basic formula of Laplace transform.